Armabat Breakout was one of the first activities of this year's colloquium. In our respective groups, we were asked to approach the concept of peoplehood. Here's a short excerpt of a longer conversation that took place in my Armabat session. Daniel. We are talking about peoplehood in the coming days, and today we are asking if there is a connection that goes beyond religion. Is there something that makes us a people? Me. Well, what is peoplehood if it's not religion, not culture? If it's something bigger, what is that bigger thing? How do we define peoplehood? Daniel. It is all of these things, plus language, race, etc. You can't check off each box, but we have enough of those things in common that it makes us a people. I don't know if there's another people that exists the same way as the Jewish people. Truth be told, before this week's colloquium, I had never given much thought to the concept of Jewish peoplehood. I hadn't considered its literal definition and the ways in which translating it into other languages is problematic. I hadn't considered its grander implications as an institution, and I certainly hadn't considered the enormous debate it would spawn amongst those of us studying to be the future leaders of the Reformed Jewish movement. As our colloquium comes to a close today, I find myself grappling with the notion of peoplehood. Definitions have been supplied and theories posed, but more than anything else, this dense topic has left me unpacking the questions, where have we come from and where are we going, to a dizzying degree? Even further, who are we? What role does religion play in peoplehood? And do our individual definitions ever meet to align? I think about the we. Though I struggle to answer these questions personally, what I understand is that this is a matter of us and not just me. I am a Jew because I am a part of something much larger than myself and part of a history much longer than my single lifetime. I find value in coming together to discuss our identity. And even if we fail to agree on a definition of who we are, the conversation evokes in me a desire to act and to educate. I am walking away from this colloquium with a stronger yearning to inspire other Jews through stories of our shared and individual pasts and through hopes for our collective future. I want to spread my passion for Judaism and further our rich, diverse, multifaceted heritage. I have a fire inside, and I want to share it with those willing to receive. What I take away from these past few days is a sense of obligation. I feel an obligation to continue learning and reevaluating my sense of Jewish peoplehood. I feel an obligation to facilitate insightful conversations with future congregants and to constantly reconsider my definition of involvement and belonging to the Jewish people. Who falls inside the figurative Jewish tent and who does not? How critical are these boundaries? How broad is our imagined community? And does stretching our borders enhance our peoplehood or weaken it? Through Steve Israel's lens, I think of how our linear Judaic timeline must lead to a better future. I think of our commandment to make the world a better place and how we can make a more significant impact on our society at large as a collective group. I reflect on Micha Odenheimer's inspiring elective on his organization, Tevel Tzedek. He believes that people gain strength from community, from being with each other, and from building a group identity. He poses that a group does not need to enclose its members, but can allow them to build outwards. Our Jewish identity, however we may individually define Jewish, as religion or culture or something slightly less tangible, can become a vehicle for building outwards. We are stronger together as a people. My sense of Jewishness will always be different, individualized, and unique. But our umbrella of Jewish identity, common origin, common language, common culture, and more can continue to serve as a connecting thread amongst Jews worldwide. My Jewish experiences and my approach to Judaism can become others' food for thought. It's true. During my time in Israel, I have fallen in and out of love with the collective Jewish people. I have felt alienated in a homeland that I always thought was meant to welcome me with unconditional acceptance. I have been confounded by a language that was supposed to be mine, and I have literally and figuratively walked down paths here that have led me to dead ends or sent me in circles. The people here in Israel are supposed to be my people, my land, but for so long I felt anything but a sense of belonging. A few months and a much-needed break later, here we are in our spring semester with barely 4 months left, and suddenly I find myself apprehensive to leave this bubble. Not just the HUC bubble, but the Jerusalem Jewish bubble. I am anxious to leave a city and a country that are inherently Jewish, a place that shares my greater history and my struggles. So I think, who will we be when we are no longer here together? Who will I be without you? How do we remain connected when we are scattered? I argue that it is our shared experiences, no matter how those experiences may vary, that will tie us together for the years to come. We will reflect on these moments and use this year as a foundation for how we will educate the people we encounter. We will use this year's colloquium topic to engage our Jewish peers and inspire others. I look forward to continuing this conversation with you as we grow together in our roles as Jewish leaders and to reconsidering our definition of Jewish peoplehood